Hello, hello. I'm the official name reader. My job is to look through the first page of Google, review the nicknames provided by the internet, and then give my recommendations at the end. Maybe it's my imagination, but that scroll felt a little bit shorter than normal. But anyway, today we're looking over Hoot Hoot and Noctowl. Archimedes I basically expected to see at some point, and in general I kinda like the name, so I'm totally fine with it, and I think it works. I'm not sure why I put it like Doctor Who, because I've seen Doctor Hoot, which is like far funnier and more clever, so it's like this guy is just one letter short of a joke. But yeah, Doctor Hoot works, but Doctor Who a little less funny. And then because we've got three in a row, Hooters, also totally fine with. I actually came up with that one myself for Rowlet, and that was the reason I decided to choose Rowlet for my starter in Gen 7, was because I came up with the nickname, got really excited, and I went with it. It works extra well if it's a girl. And then Mr. Owl, I'm totally fine with that too. I saw that in another thread, and it, you know, made me think of the how many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop commercial. So that one's also totally fine. Kaipora, I also have written down. That's the owl from Ocarina of Time, Kaipora Gabora. I don't think both of it's gonna fit, so you're just gonna have to shorten it to Kaipora. I think it works. I think anyone that knows the owl's name is gonna get it, because I don't know if everyone knows it. I don't know. I haven't read the text in Ocarina of Time in over 10 years, so. Blathers, that's a good choice as well. Yeah, I don't really have anything extra to say about it. Just kind of pick your reference. Hedwig, that's another one I expected to see. It works. Not too much to say about it. Yet again, pick your reference. This is going great lengths for one nickname, but I want to say that if anyone out there actually does this idea, I love you, because that's stupid and hilarious. Robin Hoot, that's another one. I feel like it's way more common these days with Decidueye. So I get it. It makes a lot more sense on him. But at the time, before he existed, Robin Hoot was a pretty good choice because more owl puns. Okay. I mostly want to acknowledge Equinox here because I, in general, like that as a nickname. I don't understand what it has to do with Noctowl, but I definitely disagree. Don't just shorten it to Nox. Call it Equinox, because no one's gonna know that Nox is short for Equinox, because why the fuck would they? But then the rest of this is just a very elaborate boob joke. So if you care about naming a different, more complicated way of saying Hooters, there's that. I also want to point out that Denny has taste. The name writer site, and if you click on it, it goes to Pokemon.net. And not the stupid Tumblr idiot. Okay, speaking of though, we gotta go through. This must be again where he originally started before he started explaining things, so I'm gonna try and skim or not waste all my time on it. Clockworks is probably the one I like best out of these. Again, I'm not sure. I mean, I guess it works for Hoot Hoot if you want to count the eye shape, but it gets lost after it evolves. And I can't think of anyone, like, the first one that comes to mind that Clockworks could fit would be Kling Klang, but that just feels too obvious to the point where it becomes boring and not cool, so I don't know, but I like the name Clockworks, I just don't think it fits Noctowl. Anything else on here I'm just not interested in, and obviously he's got his fair share of cringe. Okay, so that's the bottom. We've seen a lot of pretty good nicknames in general, if I'm honest. It kind of comes down to pick your reference. But let's finish up by checking the spreadsheet. I think if you wanted to take this route, maybe name it Sugimori instead of just Ken, because Ken could be literally anything, like Ken from Barbie, for instance. Maybe Sugimori might be a little bit more obvious because, you know, it's his last name, and he works on Pokemon, and yeah. Alright, I've seen this a couple times. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't know that. Like, watching through the anime, because I even rewatched it recently, and I'm still going through it, like, I never noticed it, never thought anything of it, because I was just like, oh, It's like the early 2000s, the 90s. They're not good at animation and coloring just yet, so it never occurred to me. But when you see them right next to each other, it becomes very, very obvious. But I think it's incredibly easy to dismiss this and just not think twice about it and just be like, oh, that's just normal. So if you never knew Ash had a shining Octowl, now you know. I learned it today too. So I was trying to focus on this one because I knew it looked familiar, but I couldn't quite place it. That's Ron's owl, and now that I realize that these, like, two things are referencing, saying, yes, this is also Harry Potter, because they just didn't feel like typing it a bunch, I recognize Errol. I think that one's, like, Dumbledore's owl, or something like that. But yeah, there's other owls in case you don't want to do Hedwig. And I've also seen Athena a bunch. I don't care. I'm just acknowledging it there, so. And a bunch of this stuff, which I don't know what this is, never heard of it before, but apparently it's popular or something, people think of it. Those are more suggestions. But again, I think we came up with a bunch of things, so I'm gonna go over the non-referential stuff first, which is really kind of. There wasn't really any of them, actually, because I mean, even Hooters is kind of a reference. Okay, well, the ones that I have written down, Archimedes, which actually surprises me that there was only one suggestion for that one. I expected to see that like 50 times, but I didn't. Blathers, Doctor Hoot, Hedwig, all the Harry Potter owls, Hooters, Kapora-Gabora, Mr. Owl. It's pick your own reference. I didn't have a personal choice for it, but honestly, I think if I had to pick one, I might just go with Kapora because I'm an Ocarina of Time loser. The thing is, none of these names have that sense of like, I'm in love with it, so I just never bothered siding with one. But none of them are bad either. Like, they're all fine, it's just I'm not passionately in love with it because it feels like something you would expect to see, if that makes any sort of sense. But other words, provide your own ideas and suggestions for Hoot Hoot and Noctowl, and give a thumbs up to the comments you like, and let's keep the discussion going.